Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to the Social.in account. This is Pradeep, and this week on the Social Media Weekly, we're talking about Google banning all face mask ads from their platform. We're talking about Firefox, yes, I said Firefox, taking on Facebook, and we're talking about Facebook incurring a 2% digital services tax. Let's get started. So the first story we have for you today is about Google banning all face mask ads from their entire platform. Even if you're a long-time Google AdWords advertiser, you will now see a message when you try to advertise your face masks saying that you should not advertise this product in this target location. And the target location, it's the entire earth. Yes, that's right. If you're an advertiser with Google AdWords, you cannot advertise face masks anywhere on planet Earth on Google's platforms. This not only includes regular old face masks, but also dust masks. If you are an advertiser trying to price gouge, or if you are an advertiser trying to sell face masks to take advantage of this COVID-19 pandemic, please don't do so. There is a link to the article in the description right next to that like button. Our next story has to do with Google My Business tightening their restrictions around photo and video posting. So a while back, if you were an advertiser or indeed a user of Google My Business, you could arbitrarily post any photo or video directly to your Google My Business page, and this would appear on the first page of Google's organic search results. You and I know as SEO practitioners how difficult it is to get any item of content on the first page, and here was Google offering you a direct channel onto the first page of Google organic search. Now Google is saying, if you are a Google My Business page user, you cannot post any photo or video without it passing through review. Obviously, the first level of review will be done by a machine, and the second level of review will be done by a human being. There is a link to the tweet in the description below. Our next story has to do with our favorite publishing platform, WordPress.com. So a couple of WordPress plugins are in trouble. The first one is the Google Analytics dashboard for WordPress, wherein if you are using this plugin and you have updated to the latest version, you will now lose all your traffic data. Exact Metrics has said that you have to re-authenticate your account with Google Analytics because there has been a change in Google Analytics API. Also, if you are using the ever popular Yoast SEO or Rank Math plugins, you will have issues with your canonical pages. As you know, canonical pages are the original pages on your website of any item of content. These pages will now have Unicode characters. Yoast has promised a fix. You can read all about it in the link in the description. Our next story has to do with everyone's favorite social network, Facebook.com. So Facebook, Amazon, Google, the social network, the online marketplace, and the search engine have been hit by a new tax in the United Kingdom, a digital services tax of 2%. So if you are any one of these companies, no matter where you are based, and you have revenues globally of exceeding £500 million from digital services, and in the UK you have revenue of £25 million, you will now have a 2% tax on all of your revenue above the first 25 million. So the first £25 million are free. While this 2% seems like a really small number, the UK government is planning to raise £500 million every year from this tax. Our final story of the day has to do with Firefox taking on Facebook. So in the latest version of Firefox, version 74, you have a new add-on called the Facebook Container add-on. If you turn this on, it will log you out of Facebook, it will close all your Facebook tabs, and it will stop Facebook adding cookies to your browser. As you know, Facebook tracks you on every other website that you visit when you have Facebook logged in. According to this container, it will store all of this in a separate section, and if you try to log in with Facebook on another website, you will have to manually add that website to your Facebook container. Also, Facebook embeds on other websites like the like button and the Facebook post embeds will no longer work. This essentially means that Firefox is creating two versions of its browser, one version which is Facebookified and the other version which is free of Facebook. That's about it for this week's episode, guys. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Drop your comments down below. What do you think of Firefox's brave attempt to counter Facebook? Let us know. Also, please go over to YouTube and subscribe to the Social.in channel. Ring that notification bell so that you never miss a video, and we will see you guys in the next week's episode.